Hi guys, Tanya here from Sarva Yoga. I have done the Leo forecast for April, so I have made a little spread, a tarot spread, so that you know what might expect you in the upcoming month. And first of all, as usual, I show you what the spread was looking like. So, and just to know the overall energies for the next month, I have drawn a card. And we got the white buffalo calf woman. Just to make you see clearly, that is her. So, I really like that picture. I mean, she's really cute. And I'm gonna read out to you what it says. She is the prophetess of the sacred way. She says, "My heart is a compass. The path of love is true abundance." That's very nice. And I'm also going to read from the little booklet that comes along with the oracle. It says, "The white buffalo calf woman is a sacred reminder that we don't have to struggle to receive all that we've desired. When we join our heart's longing with action, we find that there's a sacred way to move through the world." I really like that. "This sacred way is a path of steady, quiet alignment between the heart's intention and our every step." Now, if that's not a good card for April, then I don't know. So, yeah. With the buffalo spirit, we go into the first week of the month. So for the first week of the month, I had the Knight of Cups and the Four of Action. So, the Knight of Cups, he can talk about a new love offering. Yeah, he can talk about chivalry, romance, gallantry, things like that. It can also talk about creating a new life in a quite barren place, in a place where you wouldn't expect that there is life to grow. Because you see him coming from quite, the background looks a little bit like a desert. Wait, I have to show you. Oh yeah, now you see it. So, even through the desert, you find a stream of water and you can start something new. So it's a card full of hope. And the Four of Action backs it up quite well, because it talks about, after a long time of work, you finally get your stability, maybe in financial ways, maybe in relationship ways. But it talks about a long period of or a prolonged time where you felt there is kind of a desert in your life, and now the reward is coming and something is starting to grow again. Yeah. In the second week of April, we have the Ten of Wands and the Guardian of Action. So again, some action. The Ten of Wands is talking about stress, burnout, and too many burdens at the same time. But this card is also having an advice for you. In order to avoid that stress in the first place, you could just start to set clear boundaries. Say no. Yeah, just say no and try to tell people that you just don't have time for this. I mean, this woman is putting all of the ones in front of her, like, excuse me? No. You know what I mean? So this card really gives you the advice, before you even start to have stress and too much on your mind, just give it up. Say, no, thank you. I'm not dealing with this. Goodbye. Yeah. And the Guardian of Action is also very nice going along with that Ten of Wands, because this guy is really a charismatic leader, yeah? And you as a Leo, you know that you were actually born to be a leader, yeah? You already have this charisma since day one. And this guy is someone who can really he knows when to give away, when it's too much work for him, so he just asks somebody else to please do it. And that's also what a good leader has to do. A good leader has to know when his job ends and when the job of his employee starts, right? So to have these clear boundaries so that everybody in the group knows where his job starts and where his job ends and what is not his responsibility anymore and what is, that is actually something very important. We need to set these boundaries, and this guy can. So these cards are telling you, you have to set these boundaries, and you can, you are able. Yeah, so this was week two. Now let's go on to week number three of April. We have the Page of Cups, and we have New Beginning. And I love this card because it has an angel. So, what does that say? Page of Cups can also talk about a new love, just like we had here with the Knight of Cups. So yeah, maybe in the first week of April you meet someone and you start dating, and maybe in the third week you have your second date. Who knows, yeah? That's just one of the things how this card could play out, yeah? He's definitely someone who brings new possibilities. So it doesn't have to be a love offer. It can be an offer of another kind. It can be a job offer. It can be an offer to help in a volunteer work. Just now in the Corona days, we have a lot of people who are needed in volunteer places, yeah? It can also be that you are just having the idea by yourself and saying, okay, I want to contribute to society. So I'm seeing, what can I do right now in my neighborhood? Yeah, maybe you have an elderly neighbor and they would be happy if you go shopping for them so that they don't take the risk to get corona or anything like that, yeah? So this is talking about new possibilities, and it's also saying let go of all the old burdens so that you can start your way into the future lightly. And the angels are definitely with you now. And this is also very much backed up by this card. I mean, the meaning of this card is really that you can start something new, and that there is the power and the energy. I mean, you can see this guy is really powerful, right? There's a lot of power and energy in that. And here it says, you have the power and the energy, and the angels are backing up what you do. So whatever idea you have, it's the right pathway, okay? And there is no reason to fear, of course. Fear is false evidence appearing real, right? So now let's go to week number four of April. We have the Two of Swords and the Helper of Emotion. So, Two of Swords. Yeah, talking about hard decisions, sometimes confusion, sometimes a little bit of information overload where you don't really know which way to go. And sometimes it can also talk about compromise, yeah? So the advice of this card is, before you even get confused and before you don't know which way to go, sit down, meditate. Get your head and your heart back together. Because sometimes our head is saying one thing, our heart is saying the other thing, and we are torn in between. And this is just what this picture says, okay? Now, in order to surrender the two, which is, by the way, yoga, to surrender the two, you can just sit down, meditate, try to go into your heart center and ask yourself, is that decision which is in front of me, is that what I really want? Is that a decision of my heart, or is that the decision of my fears? Am I trying to protect myself from something by doing this? Yeah, and I just was in such a situation, so it was really like I asked myself, do I really want to move to that new apartment? And my inner voice immediately said, no, you don't want to move because you hate moving and you've already moved a lot. But then I asked, yeah, why do I do this? Yeah, because we're afraid. We're trying to run away before we get into the situation of losing this apartment. So I was honest to myself, saying, okay, I cannot run and do something just because of fear. That's just a wrong basis for any decision. Your base of decisions should always be love, right? And not fear. So sit down, meditate, so that you avoid this kind of state. And you've got help. You've got the helper of emotion. Yeah, there is help coming. And this helper of emotion, that can be, well, it's in a lot of times it's talking about romance. Yeah, we had that romance topic here at the start of the reading in week number one. Then we also had it a little bit in week number three, and now in week number four, it's coming back totally, yeah? So this guy, it's possible that this person, doesn't have to be a guy necessarily, right? This person is making you a wedding proposal, or saying they want to date you, or saying they want to go to the next step of the relationship. They don't want to date anymore, they want to have a very serious relationship with you. Maybe they say they want to move together with you. Yeah, you never know. But this is a typical, the helper of emotion is a typical sign of something like that coming into your life. Yeah, so it could also be that you're invited to the wedding of someone else, but this is a kind of energy that brings people together in love. So it could also be that somebody gives you a flower or a poem or is writing a love letter to you or whatever. So I think with the buffalo calf woman spirit as the underlying energy for April, we have a very good basis, because she's saying go from your head into your heart, go from your mind into your space of love and creativity, and go from fear to love, because that's the true guiding way, right? So I think overall the energy is really good. We have nothing to fear. The angels are here. We are guided by the angels, as we have seen here. So it's always immer die Spiegelung. So I hope you have a great rest of March. It's only one more week, and then go into April lightly and without fear, because everything is going to turn out fine in the end, like it always did up until now. And I wish for you to have peace, to have health, prosperity, and to enjoy whatever is there in this moment. Bye, guys.